Hey everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and welcome to my very first ever Let's Play of Train Station Renovator, or Renovation. And what I'm going to call this fictional company, just for the benefit of these Let's Plays that is my new videos to come for July 2022, is I'm going to call it Tash Renovations, and I think it's very fitting. So what we're going to do, I'm going to pick the background. Well, first and foremost, let's put the name in, shall we? Okay, folks, I just had to turn the caps lock off, as that is also the button I use to torque to use. And anyways, I'm just going to click on this one here and making sure my cursor is on the arrow there, as it's not very big, to say the least. Anyways, just going to have a wee look through the logos. I think that's a very nice one for us to start with. And what we're going to do, folks, we're going to start off with all of the missions. And these videos will be split into parts. So part one will be for mission one. So I would imagine that one will be a very short video. I won't bother with the tutorial, as you know. I just want to jump straight into the game and hopefully strive for 100% in all of the levels. Whether that's doable or not, I don't know. I'm just a casual game player, folks, okay? But anyways, it's great to be doing something different. It is transport related, obviously, and it is railway. So I'm just going to move my cursor over there and let's get started. First and foremost, we do have a very nice model railway here. And if we click on the station, and I'm just using the controller and the touchpad, as to be honest with you, I don't use the mouse when I'm narrating as much because of the clicking noise, and I try not to get that on the microphone, as I'm using the built-in one on this gaming PC. So I'm just going to hold that down and then drag this locomotive onto here. But as you do jobs and stuff, you do unlock additional wagons and stuff. I'm assuming this is roughly based on an ES44 AC. So what we'll do, we'll just set this train up and we'll let it run and then we'll leave the room. And I think it's a very nice, thoughtful novel. A novel feature that this game has. And I got this game for an absolute bargain. If you are into these simulations of this kind of thing, I'd definitely recommend it. But there we go, folks. We got the train done. So we just click on create and likewise, just use the C button just to move the train. And that, my friends, we will cover more on this later as we unlock more features, but you do get a virtual model railway included. So let's return back to our main office then, and then let's make a start on the first mission. As you know, I'm just going to pan the camera down, and I'm just going to do this as our very first thumbnail image, okay? So just going to hit F12 there. And that's our thumbnail for this video. And without further ado, let's get stuck in on mission one then. The tasks are very much self-explanatory, but we can use tab to go to the tasks that are needed to be done. And for those of you that are very much used to car mechanic simulator and stuff, the interface is very much identical. But anyway, folks, what I'm going to do, I'm going to start by cleaning up that horrible graffiti on this building over here. So I'm going to use the mouse to steer, and we can just establish a mixed or a segregated container. I tend to go for segregated for this part. And what I'm going to do, I will put a general one at the other end of the site as well. And generally, you are working as a renovator, obviously. And this is a very nice novel game, in my opinion. So, to be honest, I won't be narrating much whilst I'm doing the jobs. So I will narrate in between them. Otherwise, it can be quite cumbersome to try and talk through the entire video. As you know, my recorder is set, so I have to press a button to talk to you, as I don't have the microphone on constantly, just in case I make a mistake and I accidentally use less than suitable chosen words, just to put it nicely, you know. Especially with the YouTube censorship and stuff, you know. Anyways, let's get stuck in, and feel free to let me know your thoughts on this new line of Let's Plays that I'm doing. Oh, by the way, folks, I just want to mention to you that you can do these tasks in any order that you want. For example, you can just pick up this litter down here. You don't have to do these in any particular order. But I'm just moving the mouse around, and I'm just using the button on the computer just to pick it up, as you know. That's all the garbage picked up off the floor. And the next thing for me to do, I'm going to attack all the graffiti first. Although you can do this in any way you want, as there is no set order in how you need to do this. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to attack this graffiti next, just to get rid of it, as it does look disgusting, to be honest. And then we'll just start by cleaning up the garbage around the site as well. Also, I do recommend using the axe just to destroy the larger pieces of garbage and stuff, as then you can just fit it all into the general trash skip without consuming too much space as well, and that will save you costs on paying to get it emptied and stuff. So our task here, folks, obviously running a virtual cleaning business and a renovation business, is to make as much profit as you can and aim for those 5 stars that you can get from each level. Okay, folks, I think it's now time for us to start overhauling the bathroom, or the restroom, as we tend to call it. And just need to get 3 bathroom elements and 1 sink. So this will be a very straightforward process. Okay then, that is the restroom done. So what we need to do is just dispose of any of the trash around and remove old furniture and stuff. And that's very much this side of the area done. Oh, by the way, folks, you can recycle these drums if you want to. But personally, I just prefer to just throw these out in the general trash. As to be honest with you, it does conserve space in the recycle bins. And as you know, that's just my preference. But if you want to recycle them, you can do. But our task here is to renovate these buildings whilst making as much profit as we can. Or at least that's how I've learned how to play this game anyways. So we'll just deal with these trash bags and stuff. And then once we've done all the cleaning up and the overhaul on the outside, and we will do the main task, we will then do work on the inside of the station building as well. As well as renovate it with new furniture and stuff. Okay, we've now opened the fuse box. What I'm going to do, I will return the tools to the truck and we will then commence on with the other tasks that is needed to be done. So we'll make our way back to the truck now. And all being well, so far so good. We are 42% of the way into this level. So what I'm going to do, I'll just have to select hands-on mode just to put the tools back in the truck. And we'll start with the outhouse first. And then what I'm going to do, I will then work on furnishing it and stuff. So I'm just going to have to use the crowbar. And that just changes the door to a nice new one. And we'll just have to get rid of this garbage that's in here. Like these rotten cabinets and stuff. So it's just a matter of getting rid of that. And we can then just select axe, move up, and then just hit these boxes and just turn it into easier to manage waste. Now I'm using the mouse. I'm hoping that the microphone is not picking up the clicking too much. Although the mouse I'm using is not as loud as the old one, but it's just easier to use the mouse just to pick up the garbage and stuff rather than messing around with the touchpad and stuff. So I'm just going to destroy these, as then it just makes it easier just to take these garbage bags and then get rid of everything. The next thing we'll have to do is furnish the storeroom. That's the utility room. One trash can, 6 furniture and 2 decorations. So that's not a bother. Okay, that's all the garbage removed from the utility room. So the next thing we'll have to do is that we will start on the station building. I'm just making sure I've got enough space in the skip, which, fingers crossed, I will have. Otherwise, it's $200 to empty the skip. So I tried to keep the expenses to an absolute minimum, just to maximize those stars and stuff, you know. And there we go, folks. We've got our 1 star and we have unlocked our first reward. I'm going for a full house on 5 stars on this level. And I will try and achieve 100% on all levels as much as I can. There may be occasions where I cannot do this, but I will aim to go for 5 stars and nothing less on all the levels, okay? Okay, that took a few tries just to clear up that garbage and stuff. So there was some weeds there that we overlooked. However, the shadows can hide them, so it just pays to be vigilant. Make sure you get everything on the task list to do. And the next thing for us to do now, folks, is to renovate the main station building. And of course, fix the socket, and which is this one here. Or it could be across the other side, but anyways. We will need to fix the socket, and then we can just simply gather some of this garbage up as well. So it's quite a bit to do in here, folks. But I'm just going to have to take a wee moment break, okay? I'm back in a minute. Apologies for that, folks. The phone rang and I just didn't want to get that on the video, okay? But likewise, let's carry on as before. And here is our task, folks. We shall now fix the socket. And that will count towards our percentage. And we are almost at, well, we've got 2 stars. And we just need 74% to get our third. And 86 and then 98%. And then we're very much done. But I'm going to go for a full house on 100%. That, my friends, was a very nice novel message to the new owner. But as I was saying there, it says clean me, so we've just done that. I'm just making sure that all the graffiti has been removed off the walls. So we just got this one to do. So very much self-explanatory here. And we will cover each level in different videos and stuff. But nonetheless, let's just get rid of these cobwebs and that then, shall we? Okay then, folks, the next thing for us to do before we furnish this station, and that includes the ticket office as well, we'll just have to remove all of the trash bags, but I will have to sweep the floor, and I'll just do that now. So we'll just finish it off in here, and once this is done, we can then do a scan just to see if there's anything else left to do. And I just want to mention as well, you can upgrade the tools once you earn enough stars. So it does pay you to do or try and get 5 stars in all of the buildings and stuff. And it is recommended. So what I'm going to do now, folks, I'm just going to press Q. And we just have big trash to dispose of. That includes recycling and general waste as well. So we'll just go into hands-on mode here. And we'll just take this bag of garbage to the recycle skip. And that should be just round the corner here somewhere along this path. And likewise, just make sure you get it in the right one. Because if you do put it in the wrong one, you will get a penalty. So make sure when you use the recycle skip, just make sure you put the correct colours in the correct compartments, just to avoid that issue, okay? This is just general trash as far as I know. And this can just go in the skip over here. And then the next thing for us to do is to just burnish the station. And we're very much done. We are 79% of the way there, folks. So it's just a matter of cleaning up and making the station look like new for its brand new owner. And to be honest with you, I do quite enjoy this game actually. Okay then, that's the main task done, but we're not done by a very, well, by a long while, as we've got to furnish this station and make it look presentable. So what we'll need is 6 benches, 3 trash cans, 2 clerks, 6 decorations, 1 food machine, and of course 1 ticket machine. And that's for the main concourse in itself. And if we just go into the office, we just need 1 chair, 3 bits of furniture, 3 electronic equipment, and of course 1 trash can. So we'll do the office first. So it's just a matter of now furnishing, and then we're near enough done. Just a wee bit of lag in the game there when I was selecting the fan, but there's nothing I can do about that. It does happen from time to time, but there's only one thing left to do, and that's to place a trash can in this office, and we are done. And the next thing for us to do will be to do the main station building, and then the station platform, and then that's this level completed. So there we go, folks. This is the office all done. Does look a lot better now, doesn't it? So next thing for us to do, the next thing is to furnish the main station building. And then we will work on the platform. And then that's everything done. That, my friends, is the main station concourse and area done. So the next thing for us to do, and we are 96% of the way done, is to do a scan just to make sure that there isn't anything left to cover. So there's no more garbage or anything to pick up. So the next thing for us to do is to go to the station platform and furnish this too. So we just need 4 benches, 2 trash cans, 1 departure board, and of course 1 clock. And then that's very much us done. Okay then, folks, we could quit here as we've now have 5 stars, but we're only 98% of the way in just, and I want 100%, so I'm going to go all out and get 100, you know. So we just need to do the clock, the departure board, and of course the trash cans, and then we're all done. That, my friends, is 100%, and I do hope you have enjoyed this first video of Train Station Renovator, and my very first Let's Play I've done of this video game. Please do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, and I do have many more of these videos to come, but as I said before at the beginning, this video will be split into several parts. And what we'll do, before we start each level off, folks, I will do the upgrades and stuff, and I will be using those stars that we earn from each level to upgrade the equipment, as in some cases, it makes completing the job much faster, okay? But anyway, folks, big thank you for watching if you stayed with me all the way through. Till next time, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, and I'll catch you in the next part.